Alrighty, fan collectors, what we're looking at today is a 56 inch Banvil Envirofan Silverline in white. This is the second Silverline I have. This came out of the same garage building that this paint business was in. And as you can see, this fan is in, so let me get closer here. As you can see, this thing is in really mint condition for an industrial fan, that is. No scuffs on the motor at all. No scratches anywhere, really. It's really rare to find them this clean. This one's also from 2005. This one's from December of 2005, so the other one's a month older. There's your Envirofan tag. And for anybody who hasn't seen, I used to own two older Silverlines, but they died on me, so I kept one of the canopies to them. There's a comparison into the sticker label. I will say the older canopy is slightly bigger. Let me show you guys your tag here. Come on, focus. There we go. There you go. Did it with, did like an A-B system so I can tell which parts go with. But yeah, the two older ones I had didn't have the rubber gaskets on the canopies. But yeah, without any further ado, I will now demonstrate the fan. I've also heard that this era of Silverline is the worst, because I heard the paint for these is just terrible. The bearings are just terrible. Performance is not that... Performance is pretty good, but I heard the motors don't last as long as New Orleans. But they, I will say, Envirofan is making a... Banvil Envirofan is making it a... has made a comeback with these. They're, the newer ones that you can order from them are a lot better than these... thousands ones here. All right, so without any further ado, I will put it on low speed. This thing performs just as well as the other one. Has really no issues. This one doesn't wobble as badly as the other one does. This one's bearings are, for some reason, a little worse. I can hear, well, I just heard it slightly. I heard the bearing was from here, slight crackling a little bit. Now it's starting to wobble, but that's normal. Yeah, I can hear them crackling. Just a slight bit, but it doesn't affect the performance of the fan at all. I'm not sure why, probably a lack of grease or something like that. I am also using the same control as last time. The Fasco 4-speed control is a non capacitor-based control. Bring it up to medium-low now. yeah, the bearings on this one crackle a little bit. But as I said before, it doesn't perform, it doesn't affect the performance of the fan. Although having the slight bearing noise that it has. I think once the motor warms up for like after a while, I think it goes away, but that's probably just me. Because I literally just installed this about 10 minutes ago. Bringing up to medium high now. As you can see, this one's got that normal industrial wobble. You really can't make an industrial fan not wobble. If you have, I'd be impressed. Alright, bring it up to high speed now. Very powerful, it's giving it really good breeze, and just to show that it is, a little Carhartt hoodie, the thing there is moving. See that? As I said in the last one, y'all better be ready to for a really long spin down, and y'all better be sitting in a comfortable chair right now, because you're in for a very, very long spin down. Like, it's longer than the other one, I think. Last I recorded the spin down. All right, here we go.
Spin down in 3, 2, 1.
We're gonna be here for a while. you guys this thing takes forever. Alright, so it's finally come to a stop. It's about time. I will end the video here, and I will see you guys in the next one. Bye.